I tell you, there was one sport I was very good in growing up, and that was water skiing, like the easiest sport. Anyone could do it. You basically hold on to a rope. Want to go faster, you have to master this amazing athletic maneuver. Actually, last winter I tried snow skiing the first time. I figured, hey, I've skied on water. This is water frozen onto a mountain. I think I can do this. So I go to the mountain. The first thing I notice is all the cool people have their own skis, and all the dorky people are renting skis in this little shed. I don't want to be them. It actually says loser ski shed. You don't want to be there. So I go over there. I'm like, excuse me, pal. I need some skis. I left my personal skis in Aspen, Vermont, when I was up there skiing. I was wondering if you can help me out. You're sure we got some skis. What do you need, 190s? 10.5B? I don't know. So he gives me the skis, the poles. I go buy a lift ticket, which is like $3,100. Put this on, which makes you eligible to ride the chair lift. Now, I don't know who invented this death machine, but... Because this is like a psycho's physics test. You have benches whipping by. Suddenly you're inside a math word problem. It's like... Estimate the velocity of a bench. Now calculate your velocity. The benches are coming at one every 1.5 seconds. How much speed do you need to cross the ice, turn, and bisect the angle? Great, the one day I don't bring my protractor with me, I could definitely use it. So I wait, I see a chair, I cut, hits me, knocks me in the side. I hear the sound, the worst sound no skier ever wants to hear, worse than breaking your leg, and that is the sound of the lift stopping. Suddenly I'm the focus of this entire mountain. I clear my eyes, I see people all the way up the mountain frozen in their chairs. Ski school skiing by, they're giving me the finger. I hear an announcement, there's a Jew down on E-lift. I think we got a Jew down on E-lift. And his outfit doesn't match. So no one has told me red plaid bell bottoms are out. Fine, I can live with that. So the lift operator picks me up, shows me to everyone in line, puts me in the chair, sends me up the mountain. Now in the chair, I decided to take out my guide to skiing, the trail map, which is an interesting piece of topography because they name each trail in conjunction with how hard the run is. Now there's hard trails, which are black trails, and then there's easy trails, which are green trails. Now, I want to go on the green trails because I'm a beginner, but they have weird names like Mama's Boy, you know. I don't want to be on that. I'm not going to be on that. There was another green trail called, Hey, Buddy, You're a Wussy. Who's skiing that? I don't know. But then I see the black trails, the diamond trails. These look good. There was one called Body Cast. Yo. Severe neck damage. Let's go. So I get to the top, I find out there's two basic ways to ski down a mountain. The first way is called snow plowing. Now, if you ski like this, please do yourselves a favor, stay home. Stay off the mountain, because you look so pathetic. They're like little, I don't know, Jerry Lewis's with their knees, breasts, really bad. I can't even describe it, I feel bad doing it. But there is a cool way to go down the mountain, that's called traversing. That's where you cut back and forth across the grain of the mountain. I said, this is it. This is for Wayne. So I get to the edge of the mountain. I say the skier's credo, which is no guts, no glory, no lunch, because you're nauseous. You can't hold anything down. So I wait, traverse to the right, cut, and traverse straight down the mountain. Now I'm flying down this mountain. I'm doubling my speed every 3 feet. Tears are pouring out of the corner of my eyes. I pass Chuck Yeager. How do I slow down? I try this. That does nothing. That's when I realized what the poles are used for. They're used to hit people out of the way as you go down the mountain. Now, sometimes you can actually stab a skier with one of these. I had like 3 skiers on 1 pole. It was like a ski kebab or something. I'm not sure what it is. Then I looked down and noticed one of my skis was sort of crawled on top of another one. And when your skis cross, a rule comes into effect called the tandem skiing rule, which states if your skis are crossed and there's anyone skiing in your vicinity, you are now allowed to hook them. This is true, because you're going down anyway. There's no doubt about it. This is just to cushion your fall a little bit. So I see this lady and the infant she's teaching. I get over to her. I get my arm around her. We go down. The Jew, he's down on the slope. And he has a hostage. Thank you very much. Thank you.